All right, come on, follow me. Now, this video has been in the making for the last 9 months, and a lot of you guys have been messaging, commenting, especially after that last post that we put on the community tab about the 120X Pro, and you've been asking, have we changed and gone to the 120X Pro? Short answer, yes. We actually went and changed it up in January, so we've been testing this thing out for the last 9 months. So without any mucking around, let's just jump straight in so you guys can have a look at the 120X Pro, and I'll run you through some of the differences between the 120X and the Pro version. Let's get it. So the question that we've been getting asked heaps is the iTech 120X Pro actually any better than the iTech 120X? iTech makes some pretty big claims with the 120X Pro, and they also made some big claims with the 120X. So let's dive straight in. I don't want to make this video too long, so we'll dive straight in and show you guys some of the advantages of the 120X Pro over the 120X. They're both protected by the same ABS plastic housing. They have the same terminal posts. Physically, they're exactly the same size, coming in at 330mm long by 173mm wide by 225mm high. And they also have the same nylon carry strap that just attaches to the very top of each battery in the cutout sections. Now, talking about the life of the battery itself, iTech have kept the life exactly the same, so 4,000 cycles to 100% depth of discharge, or 8,000 cycles to 50% depth of discharge, which should get you around 10 years. iTech also described both units as 100% drop-in replacements for AGM and lead-acid style batteries, meaning you can plug in your existing lead-acid battery charger and you should be able to charge these things up, no worries. Now, in the testing that we've done, you can definitely charge the 120X Pro off a lead-acid style charger, but you're not going to get a full 100% capacity by charging that way. You're going to get between 96 and 98% full capacity, but you can still definitely charge off a lead-acid charger. All right, so you told me the similarities, Luke, but what are the differences between the 120X and the 120X Pro? The main difference between the 120X Pro and the original 120X is iTechworld have gone back to the drawing board and they've actually fixed the capacity issue. You guys might remember that I did a video on the 120X capacity problem. If you haven't had a look at that one, I'll leave it down in the description box below, but iTechworld have gone back and fixed that drama. This is actually now a true 120 amp hour usable capacity in the 120X Pro, as opposed to about the 94 to 95 that I got in my tests. So that is the first big difference between the 120X Pro and the original 120X. Now, another difference to the units, this one isn't such a big deal, but this is what I think iTech have done to fix the capacity issue. They've added more cells to the 120X Pro. The 120X has, I believe, fewer cells than the 120X Pro, which leads into point number two, which is the 120X Pro is about 1.5 kilos heavier than the 120X. The 120X original version comes in at 11 kilos, where the 120X Pro comes in at 12.5 kilos. Now, that shouldn't be a big deal. If you're going from lead acid to lithium, you're still gonna get that big reduction in weight, but you're gonna get the benefit of an actual 120 amp hour usable capacity now. Now, I just wanna run through a couple of the features that I think are pretty key for the 120X Pro. So the first one being it's IP67 rated. Now, that is a waterproof rating, but I prefer to think of it as water resistant. It's rated to be underwater for up to a meter for 30 minutes, which is absolutely awesome. Second one is iTech do specify this for underbonnet use. So you can run these things under your bonnet if you don't want to put them in your canopy or in the back of your four-wheel drive. These things will take up a bit of room if you are running in a wagon. So definitely a good feature to be able to mount this thing under your bonnet and run it that way. Next one is the multi-angle fitments. iTech state that you can mount this thing at a 90-degree angle anyway from where it's sitting right now. So you can mount this thing in on its back, you can mount it on its side, you can mount it on its front, any variant of 90 degrees from there. So that's a really good feature. If you're trying to work with a tighter little space, that is actually a good feature to have. Another good feature of the 120X Pro is it is 100% Australian designed. Now, I'm not sure if these are manufactured in Australia. I'll go out on a limb and say no. Working in the mining industry, I know that a massive majority, if not all, of our lithium in Australia gets exported overseas, where it's made into products and then shipped back to us. So I'm not totally sure if this is Australian made and manufactured, but I know for a fact that it is Australian designed. Everything is built to iTechworld specifications, and all the design work is done in-house in Australia and Perth. Now, the last feature is probably the most important one that I'll talk about, and it is the warranty period. iTech offers a 60-month, yep, 5-year warranty for a full replacement. If this iTech 120X Pro was to just blow up tomorrow, if something was to really go wrong with it, if it was to have a catastrophic failure, they would send me out another one, no questions asked. All I've got to do is send this one back so they can analyze what went wrong so they can improve it for next time. A lot of battery manufacturers won't give 5-year warranties, especially being that 5-year warranties is when most batteries will start to slow down. For iTechworld to give a 5-year warranty, that is a really good indication, in my opinion, that they're going to stand by this product and actually honor if something goes wrong. Like I said to you guys at the start, I've been testing this thing for almost 10 months, so it has copped an absolute flogging from us, from charging to completely discharging this thing 100% flat, to pulling up to 1500 watts out of the inverter and powering big current drawing appliances like induction cookers, air fryers, coffee machines, that sort of stuff. We have definitely put this thing through its paces, and the only thing that I can say, this is my one problem with the battery so far. It's discharge rating. I'm not sure if I've got one that just can't quite make it, but I've had a problem getting this thing up to 150 amps discharge. Now, if you look, I'll cut this on the screen so you can see it, but if you look on iTech's spec sheet for the 120X Pro, you can see that its continuous discharge rating, I'll highlight it there so you can see, is 150 amps. That tells me that you can pull 150 amps continuously out of this battery until it goes flat. Straight above that, you can see that there's another rating there for a 5-minute discharge. That's 175 amps. I haven't been able to get this thing to hit 150 yet. So I've reached out to iTechworld. Now, mind you, I only reached out to them last week, so I'm not expecting an answer back very quickly, because obviously they've got to do their own tests and things as well. But that is so far the only gripe that I have against this battery. So this is actually kind of funny. I'm in the middle of doing this video now, and it just occurred to me that I haven't had the original 120X on a charge since we put the 120X Pro in. So that was a little bit over 10 months ago. So pretty good. I've just wired it back into our solar setup just to pump a little bit more charge in there. It was down, almost about to go into safe mode. So good to know that it lasts 10 months without having any charge or anything done to it, and it's still hanging in there. But anyway, guys, I hope that's answered some of your questions that you might have had about the iTech 120X Pro, or the differences between the 120X Pro and the 120X, the original version. Now, guys, if you want to know more detail about either of them batteries, I'll leave a link down in the description box below. That'll take you over to the website. I've done write-ups on both of these batteries, and it just lets me go into a bit more detail than what I can do on YouTube just for time and that sort of thing. But anyway, guys, check that link out. And if you want to know more about our 12-volt system, you're going to have to watch that video up in the corner there, and make sure you subscribe to the channel so you don't miss a beat. I'll see you over there.